EG4 mini splits are simple, very efficient, and easy to install. We've had this one installed in our garage for a couple months at this point. Our garage is about 700 square feet, but it has really high ceilings. If you equated the ceilings down to like an 8-foot ceiling, it would be equal to about 1100 square feet. It's also a garage, so it's got poorly insulated garage doors. The walls are actually very poorly insulated. We found out while we were installing this. Point here is, we've had this thing installed. It's been winter outside and we've been pushing it pretty hard for the last couple months. And so today, I think that we're ready to share our experience with EG4's biggest 2-ton, 24,000 BTU mini split. When it comes to heating and cooling your home, there has been two main things that have always kind of plagued this industry. The first one is no one understands it. It seems extremely confusing and complex. You need people that are certified to come in and tag things and make sure that it's done correctly. It's way above most people's pay grades. And number two is the cost. It's pretty expensive to buy, fix, install, even just run things like an air conditioner or a heater. That's what takes up the bulk of most people's utility bills. Now, EG4 didn't invent the mini split. They've been getting quite popular over the last couple of years, but what EG4 is really good at doing is taking a product that already exists and just making it a little bit better, keeping it affordable and offering some good support. So we had pretty high hopes when we got our hands on our first EG4 mini split. As always, we have some coupon codes and links down below if you guys want to check out this product or anything else. We have some coupon codes you can save some money on Signature Solar's website. Before we get any further, we're going to give you guys a super quick 60-second spec teardown in case you're not already familiar with the 2-ton 24,000 BTU mini split. First up, both pieces pass the tiny baby lift test. The outdoor unit is 75 pounds, although it's really awkward. Like you can't pick it up by yourself. You're gonna need two people. The indoor unit is just over 20 pounds. And it's also, just quick note, it's 33 inches wide in case you're trying to size up what that might look like inside of your house. This is a hybrid unit, so you can power it directly with AC power from the grid, or you can run a solar array directly into the unit and power it purely off of solar panels. As we already mentioned, this is the 24,000 BTU version. It's the biggest one that they currently offer. They do have like three or four smaller ones below it, I believe. And I think those ones run off 120. This one actually requires 240 volts to get it going. And the square footage that this thing's rated to heat or cool is actually 650 to about 1350 square feet. The solar input is rated for 2,200 watts of input, which is basically just under the maximum amount of power that we've ever even seen it use. And this unit, with our discount code, costs $1,849, which is actually not terrible for what you're getting, so long as what you're getting actually works as advertised. Installing this thing was actually a breeze. If you're handy enough to do light work around your house, you can 100% tackle installing this. The unit and the components, when you first unbox them, admittedly can be a little daunting. Even I was like, I don't know about this, but honestly, after installing it, it was really simple. It took us a total of about 2 hours, never having done it before. It took Josh, our gingerbread man editor, about 2 hours, I should say. It wasn't really me. Honestly, it was super easy. You just mount the bracket for the interior unit on the inside of the wall. You punch a hole through the wall so you can pass your wiring and your lines through there. Go ahead, mount the unit, shoving your lines and wires through that hole so that they're exposed outside. We got the extra bracket, was $25, which is actually a really good deal. It looked a little flimsy when we were setting it up, but it actually proved to be quite stable. It was actually went on really simple. You just mount the one cross piece and then the little legs just kind of clip on, lift the unit onto the bracket, make sure you bolt it on there so it doesn't come flying off. And then it's just a matter of connecting the lines from the interior unit, running them over, connecting them to the exterior unit, connecting a power line, connecting your solar lines, and then tidying up the exposed wires lines, maybe spray foaming the hole a little bit, and you're pretty much done. It's a really simple process. And in terms of functionality, the most we've seen this thing use is about 2,700 watts. It's been averaging about 2,500 watts with turbo mode on when it's heating the garage, and it has been pretty cold. We first started using it, it was about 10 degrees Celsius outside. It starts really softly. It's not like an air conditioner where when you turn it on, it like has a big surge and then it kind of calms down. This unit actually kind of starts really slowly. And at first it's kind of annoying, but if you think about it, being able to run strictly off solar panels, it makes sense. So it starts really, really soft and it kind of builds up the wattage that it's actually using as it gets going. It has a little remote. It also has an app. I've tended to just use the remote, walk in the garage and fire it up. But if you had this inside of your house and you were spending time in that room, it'd be super easy to just fire up the app. I hate downloading apps that are just clearly from China, but this one actually seems to work not too bad. Otherwise, it works as expected. There's nothing really major to note. When it comes to things we like, it's 100% energy efficient on days where there is solar present. So if you have panels running into this thing and the sun is obviously shining, you can actually heat or cool whatever room you're trying to do 100% free of the grid, which is actually really nice in places where, like in Texas, Arizona, that kind of, you know, location where like during the day it's hot as balls and you want to cool it. And overnight you might actually get away with not needing to cool it at all. So you might not even need to run it off of grid power during the night. You might literally just be able to let it shut down and come back with the sun, which is a cool feature. And if you do need to tap into the grid wherever you are to power it at night, at least the utilities are usually cheaper during the nighttime. So not only does it save you money by not running off the grid during the day, but when it is running off the grid, it's running off like the cheapest available time slot. We also like how easy it is to install. The actual interior unit has knockouts on both sides, so you don't have to send the wire through the wall. If you had like a concrete wall or whatever, you could run the wire along the inside and out of a different wall. Very easy to install. It comes with pre-charged lines, so you don't actually have to have anyone come in and help you at all. You used to have like an HVAC guy come in and charge your lines up or whatever, but this one, they call it plug and cool. Basically, once you get the lines all installed, all you got to do is just back the little screw off. When you do that, Freon will shoot into your system that was already inside of that line, and you're good to go. You don't have to call anyone to help you with the install unless you actually need it. There's no special tools or training involved. It's so simple. A gingerbread man can do it. We really like the $25 bracket. Honestly, for 25 bucks, I would recommend anyone that's questioning it to just get it. It works really well. It installs very easy. It's got a bubble level on there so you can't mess it up. Otherwise, you're mounting it to the ground. You got to buy rubber feet to kind of isolate it or something. But that bracket for 25 bucks, it's like 25 bucks, dude. We really like the interior unit. It actually looks really professional and clean. Like, it's very sleek. A lot of inverters and stuff that we see from EG4, it's like, that's cool, but you wouldn't want it like in your bedroom, you know, like it doesn't look like that. But they did a really good job of having the interior unit looks really nice. Like, I would put it in my house in a visible spot. I think it looks good. The app is also pretty cool because you can preheat or pre-cool the room that you're trying to be in before you're actually in it. So in our case, the garage, we don't actually have to go to the garage to heat it up to go out there to do some work. We can just sit in here on our phones, click heat, it heats up. And then once it's warm, we go into the garage and do our work like absolute first world kings. When it comes to things we don't like, there's two, that's it. There's just two things that I just really don't like. And the first one is that the unit drones. This could be due to the fact that we use the wall bracket. This could be due to whatever. The point is, the exterior unit, when it comes on and starts running, you can hear like a droning sound throughout our house. It's mounted out on the far front corner near the garage, nowhere near where we are. But if we're inside just hanging out and it comes on, you can kind of hear it droning. And that's one thing that drives me nuts. Like, I'm okay with hearing the interior unit, the fan running, whatever, that's part of it. Your furnace is running, you hear that going, but it's like having like the one window down in the back seat of your car and it does the thumping. It's just annoying. And I don't know if it's something that EG4 has the ability to fix or if that's just a mini split problem, but I just don't love that. The other thing I don't like is that this unit is rated to work up to negative 15 degrees. We, for the last week or so, have had negative 12 to negative 10 degrees, but with a load of wind, and it says it feels like negative 20. In that temperature range, even when it's negative 12 with no feels like negative 20, negative 10, it doesn't really heat. Like, it will maintain, but if we turn it off for the weekend and then we come in on Monday and we turn on the mini split and it's negative 10 out, the garage doesn't get hot. It just blows kind of like a gently warm, it's like a hot breath into the garage. We have another heater.
Disgusting.
It's true though, dude. But then we have like the big heater that we have to turn on to heat the garage, and then the mini split will maintain. And so that's just one thing is I don't love is that it's rated to work down to a certain temperature, but it's kind of, I would say anything below like -5, it just doesn't seem to really heat. They're not built yet to work in super cold climates like where we live. Gonna be great for air conditioning in the summer. They're still basically designed to work in somewhere like Texas where like it gets cold in the winter, but not that cold and not for that long. And you won't really have that much of a problem. It'd be cool to see these things start being able to be designed to work somewhere like where we live, where it's f***ing cold outside. And I want to be warm. At the end of the day, we are heating a massive, poorly insulated garage.
There's no insulation.
Good news.
Which is kind of like an unfair test. If we had this thing blowing into the house, even if it was just maintaining, it would probably still do a lot better. There's less cold air leaking into the place. We're not saying it doesn't work good. We're just saying when it gets down to like those really, really, really cold temperatures, at the end of the day, free heat or air conditioning when you have it coupled with solar panels is the reason that these things are so popular. You can get a pretty big one like this and it can heat main areas in your house. You could have a smaller one in just one room of your house. And then if you had like an outage, a storm, anything, and you wanted to conserve the battery power that you did have, you could run just that room, which is kind of the pro versus like a furnace. You have to heat your whole house, air conditioner, you have to cool the whole house. These, if you have like a few spread out throughout your house, you could afford for like very little amount of power draw on your batteries to heat one or two rooms while the power is out and then heat the rest of the house when you get power back. That's why they're popular. That's what we think these things really shine for. Overall, we had a good experience with the EG4 big boy. I would like to get our hands on a small boy and see how that does. Like I said, there's links in the description down below. Let us know if there's anything else you would like to see us test mini splits through in future videos. That is all we got for you guys. I will catch you next time. Thank you so much for watching. Peace out and stay charged.